Happy morning, children. Again, I am welcome you to the online science class for the 8th standard. Okay. In the previous video, you have started a lesson, isn't it? Materials, metals and non-metals. Okay. Some elements are discovered or divided into some categories that are metals and non-metals according to their physical and chemical properties. Okay, in the previous video we have learned that what are the physical properties. Okay, it's just a recall, children. What are the physical properties of metals? They are hard, lustrous, malleable, ductile, sonorous and good conductors of heat and electricity. But non-metals do not show these properties except some non-metals. Okay, and remember one thing, mercury is the only metal which is exist in the liquid state. Okay, let us move into the chemical properties of the metals and non-metals. Okay, chemical properties means their reaction with some substances. Okay, they will how do they react with some substances? Like for example, oxygen, water, some solutions are blue litmus and red litmus experiments. Okay, this will show the differences between metals and non-metals. Okay, these are called as chemical properties. Okay, first one is reaction with oxygen. Okay, metals and non-metals reaction with oxygens. Okay, you may see in the previous class, that is in the 7th standard, you have learnt about the rust, isn't it? In our home, we have in the windows, there will be grid, isn't it? In that grills, after a few years, the rust will be formed. Okay, this is nothing but the oxidation of the that metal. Okay, that metal ion. Oxidation means metals are combined with oxygen and new substances are formed. Okay, when iron is combined with oxygen, the new substances formed is called as rust. Okay, forming of rust in iron is an example of reaction with oxygen. Iron reacts with oxygen. Okay, in the book they have given an activity in page number 46. Okay, what they have given in the activity is they said to collect some rust. Okay, collect some rust in a test tube and dissolve it in a very little amount of water. Okay, we have to dissolve the rust in a very little amount of water. After that, you may see the rust remains suspended in water. Okay, now we have to test the solution with the red and blue litmus papers. Okay, if we tested means it will turn, the solution will turn red litmus to blue litmus. Okay, it won't affect the blue litmus. Okay, it only changes the red litmus into blue litmus. It shows no effect with the blue litmus. Okay, so from this we may conclude that is metal ion is a metal. Okay, because metals or metallic oxides didn't show any effect with the blue, but they turn red litmus into blue litmus paper. Okay, next one, copper. Okay, in your home you may use copper vessels, isn't it? In that after a few years or a few months later, you may see a green deposit of on the copper vessels. Okay, you may see the green deposit on the copper vessel. This is due to the reaction of copper with oxygen. Okay, reaction of copper with oxygen, then only we can get the green deposit, right? Okay, so copper is also reacting with oxygen. This is also called, this process is also called the oxidation. Okay, when whatever material, whatever substance that reacts with oxygen and form a new substance, that is called oxidation. Okay. So next one, we have to test it for the blue litmus. Okay. So from the like that many metals we can see that they are reacting with oxygen. Okay, but all the solutions are of the these materials will only affect with and only show effect with the red litmus into blue litmus. They do not show any effects on blue litmus. So oxide, these oxides of all metals are basic in nature. Okay, because bases only changes the red litmus into blue litmus. So from these experiments we can conclude that metallic oxides are basic in nature. Okay, if the metal is, any metal is react with oxygen, it will form its metallic oxides. Okay, so these metallic oxides are basic in nature. Next one, reaction with non-metals. Okay, reaction of oxygen with non-metals. Okay, for this they have given an activity 4.4. They have taken spoon sulfur. Okay, sulfur in a deflagrating spoon. We may send it to the vessel, and the vessel will, and the we can burn it. Okay, that's that spoon is called as deflagrating spoon. Okay, if you don't have the spoon, means we can take the metallic cap of any bottle. Okay, any bottle, and wrap it with a metallic wire. Okay, in the picture 4.4A. okay, so we have to insert the deflagrating spoon full of sulfur powder, and we have to insert into the gas jar or glass tumbler with which contains oxygen. Okay, and already in the atmosphere we have oxygen, isn't it? We have insert the spoon full of sulfur into the gas jar, something. Okay, and also we have to check the gas formed is won't escape from that jar. Okay, next, after some time keep that spoon inside. After some time you can remove, you can take the spoon. Okay, you can take the spoon, then you have to add some quantity of water, add some small quantity of water into the tumbler. Okay, and immediately you have to replace the lid. Then shake the tumbler well. Okay, shake the glass jar or the tumbler well. Okay, next the solution will be formed in the. We have to check that solution with the blue and red litmus papers. Okay. Okay, that name of solution is called as sulfur dioxide gas. Sulfur dioxide gas. Okay. Okay, in that there will be gas. Sulfur with oxygen. Sulfur reacts with oxygen and forms sulfur dioxide. Okay, this when sulfur dioxide is dissolved in water, sulfurous acid is formed. Okay, so the solution is called as sulfurous acid. Okay, in page number 48 we can see the equation. Sulfur dioxide plus water gives sulfurous acid. Okay, this sulfurous acid turns blue litmus into red because it is acidic in nature. Okay, because it is acidic in nature, we are seeing about the non-metals. Okay, so when non-metals react with oxygen, they will form the acids. Okay, when it is turned its solution, it will form as acids. Okay, acids only changes the blue litmus into red. So from this example, we have concluded that all the non-metals react with oxygen. Okay, react with oxygen and form their acid. Okay, and form their acid, which are acidic in nature. Okay, so okay, from this from the above examples, we have concluded that in general, metallic oxides are basic in nature. Metallic oxides means metals react with oxygen and form the metallic oxides. Okay, if iron is reacted with oxygen, means iron, for iron the name is ferric. Okay, it will form the ferric oxide. Okay, so that any metal react with oxygen and form their metallic oxides, and these metallic oxides are basic in nature. Okay, you may already learned about bases and acids, isn't it? So all the metallic oxides are basic in nature. Okay, though they do not show any effects on blue litmus, but they change the red litmus into blue litmus paper. Okay, next is the oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature. When non-metals react with oxygen, they form the oxides of them. These non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. Therefore, they will change the blue litmus into red. Okay, litmus paper is the experimental purpose. Okay, by that test, we can find which is a metal, non-metal. Okay, something like that. So oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature. When these oxides, non-metallic oxides, combine with water, they form their respective acids. Okay, respective acids. Okay, so up to this we have seen, and also I will attach a video. Okay, let us watch the video about the topic. Carefully, children, it will be very useful to you. Okay, let us watch the video.
We have seen the different ways of preparing oxygen in the laboratory. Let's look at different reactions of oxygen. We start with the reactions of oxygen with non-metals. Whenever oxygen is added to any substance, we call it oxidation. So in this case, when oxygen reacts with non-metals, we say the oxidation of non-metal takes place. So we'll have a look at some of the reactions. Observe, we have some really interesting reactions there. So the first reaction is the reaction of sulfur with oxygen. So we first take sulfur in a spatula and heat it, because we have to take burning sulfur. It is then introduced in the jar containing oxygen gas. So as you see, it burns with a blue flame. The reaction taking place in this case is sulfur reacts with oxygen to form sulfur dioxide. We say it is heated because we use burning sulfur. So when burning sulfur is introduced into a jar containing oxygen, it forms sulfur dioxide. Since oxygen is being added to the non-metal, this is known as oxidation of the non-metal. Now, whenever we have any non-metallic oxide, it is made to react with water, it forms the corresponding acid. So sulfur dioxide, when it reacts with water, it forms sulfurous acid. Next, we take carbon. Carbon, when it is heated in the presence of oxygen, it burns to form carbon dioxide, and we see a yellow flame. So the reaction taking place is carbon reacts with oxygen. When it is heated, it forms carbon dioxide gas. It burns with a yellow flame. Again, this is a non-metallic oxide. When the non-metallic oxide is treated with water, it forms the corresponding acid. So carbon dioxide forms carbonic acid. that is H2CO3. Next we take phosphorus. Let's see the reaction of phosphorus with oxygen. So phosphorus is taken on the spatula. It is heated as we take burning phosphorus. The conical flask contains oxygen gas. Observe what happens. It burns with a yellow flame and produces dense flames. So phosphorus burns with yellow dense flames in oxygen. So the reaction taking place is phosphorus reacts with oxygen to form P2O5. And when this non-metallic oxide P2O5 is made to react with water, we get the corresponding acid. In this case, we get phosphoric acid, that is H3PO4. So we have seen that when sulfur reacts with oxygen, it burns with a blue flame. Carbon, on reaction with oxygen, burns with a yellow flame. And phosphorus, when it reacts with oxygen, it burns with dense yellow flames. And all these non-metallic oxides, when they react with water, they form the corresponding acids. Complete the reaction. We have carbon dioxide. It is made to react with water. We know that whenever a non-metallic oxide is made to react with water, it forms the corresponding acid. In this case, we have carbon dioxide reacting with water, so the corresponding acid is H2CO3. That is carbonic acid. Next, let's see the reaction of oxygen with metals. In this case, when oxygen reacts with metals, we call it the oxidation of metals. So we start with sodium. The sodium burns with atmospheric oxygen and it forms golden yellow flames. So the reaction taking place in this case is sodium. It reacts with oxygen when it is heated and it forms Na2O. That is, it forms the corresponding metal oxide. And when the metallic oxides, they react with water, all the metallic oxides form the corresponding hydroxides. So in this case, Na2O, which is a metallic oxide, it reacts with water to form NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide, which is the corresponding metal hydroxide. Let's take a calcium piece. So you see that it burns with brick red flames. So when calcium reacts with oxygen, it forms calcium oxide, that is the metallic oxide. And when this metallic oxide reacts with water, it forms the corresponding hydroxide, that is calcium hydroxide. Now let's see what happens when magnesium is burned in the presence of oxygen. So we take magnesium ribbon and it is introduced into a jar containing oxygen. It burns with dazzling white flames. So when magnesium reacts with oxygen, it forms magnesium oxide, and this metallic oxide on reaction with water forms the corresponding hydroxide, which is magnesium hydroxide. Now let's look at a very interesting reaction, the reaction of iron with oxygen. Iron coil is introduced into a jar containing oxygen. You see shower of sparks being produced. Because of this type of reaction taking place, iron is used in fireworks. So when iron reacts with oxygen, it forms Fe3O4, and Fe3O4 does not react with water. It is insoluble in water. So when we have the different metals, they form the corresponding oxide. That is, all the metals, they form the corresponding metal oxides on reaction with oxygen. And the metallic oxides, when they react with water, they form the corresponding metal hydroxides. And we had seen the different colored flames. When we heat sodium in the presence of oxygen, we get a golden yellow flame. When calcium is heated in the presence of oxygen, we get brick red flame. The reaction of magnesium gives dazzling white flame, and iron burns in the presence of oxygen, producing shower of sparks. another very important reaction shown by oxygen, all hydrocarbons. As the name suggests, hydrocarbons are the compounds that contain only carbon and hydrogen. So all the compounds containing carbon and hydrogen only, when they react with oxygen, they form carbon dioxide and water. So all the hydrocarbons, that is the compounds containing only carbon and hydrogen, when they react with oxygen, they produce carbon dioxide and water. So the different types of reactions that we have seen, when the metals, they react with oxygen, they form the corresponding metal oxides. The metallic oxides, when they react with water, they form the corresponding metallic hydroxides. And when we take the non-metallic or non-metals, the non-metals react with oxygen to form the non-metallic oxides. And all the non-metallic oxides, when they react with water, they form the corresponding acids. And also, one very important reaction of oxygen is in the hydrocarbons. All hydrocarbons, they react with oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water. So these are some of the very important reactions of oxygen.
Okay, it's enough, children. We will see in the next video, children. Watch this video carefully. Okay.